Right, Ryan here, and welcome to this module where we are wrapping up the kickoff with the team. So I hope you've really enjoyed what you've learned so far, and hopefully your mind is buzzing and you're beginning to think about the changes that you need to make to be successful. So to wrap up this week and this kickoff here, what we wanted to do is provide some demonstration and role play of how it looks, how a role play looks, a little bit of my coaching, and that this should be a very insightful time that you guys can press pause, go back and forward, and really learn a lot from over and over again, and you guys can always reflect back. So really what I want to do is cover what going from first to third looks like. So I'm going to demonstrate a role play, and then I have some students that will also receive some coaching from me and the group. So you'll find that when you begin doing these role plays, that it's really not about me or about, you know, just your sales leader. This is about an opportunity for everybody to begin to help everybody grow. So you'll kind of notice the way I describe it in the video, where how everybody can really benefit from one another when they demonstrate and they take the risk and get out there and be the guinea pig for these this new process. So again, you're going to meet some resistance. It's going to be a little different. You're going to feel friction as you're beginning to change, but let's take action. Let's grow, because I guarantee you, you guys master this and you get good at it quickly, you're going to be leaps and bounds better than everybody. You will make things predictable. Sales nirvana will begin to become a reality, and you're going to grow like crazy. So go ahead and tune in, enjoy these videos, and this one's a little longer than normal, but I really hope that you can gain a lot of this, and then at the end, you'll, of course, have your action items and discussion that you need to have, and if you're completely solo watching this, you know, take your notes and go over it with a friend, a peer, and or jump on the weekly Q&A calls so you can get some support. And anybody as well who's watching this knows they can get that support. So go ahead and enjoy this module as we go into a couple of examples, me demonstrating and a couple of those other students and that I coach, and you'll enjoy it.
So Lee came in, it got assigned to Leland, and as far as you know, Grant, you just are, you know, you're just waiting for someone to contact you now that you've made your inbound contact, and ready to go.
Hello, Grant.
Hey.
Grant, this is Leland at CFS Roofing. How are you doing today?
Doing good, Leland. How are you?
I'm doing well. So I have a work order here for 123 Soccer Stadium Avenue. It says here you're having roofing issues.
Yes, I am. Quite a few issues, leaks all over the place.
All right, and tell me a little bit more about that.
Just leaks, you know, water is coming through where it's not supposed to come through.
All right, and how long has this been an issue?
About 6 months now.
All right, so you want to go ahead and make an appointment? I got an opening on Tuesday at 10 a.m. How's that sound?
That's not going to work.
All right, what's your schedule like?
Friday. At like 6 o'clock.
All right. Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Friday at 6 p.m.
Great.
All right, sounds good. See you then.
Okay.
I'm just going to straight up say that work order lead in to say that, hey, that's why I called you. That's pretty spot on.
Okay. It's good.
Hey, Grant. It's Leland, CFS Roofing.
How's it going?
Good. So, understanding you got some issues going on with your roofing?
Yeah, man, we do. We've got leaks all over the place. I don't know if it's caused by birds or soccer balls flying on the roof. I'm not sure.
All right, and so you said this has been an issue for about 6 months?
Yeah, as far as I know, about 6 months now.
All right, and have you tried to fix this in the past, or?
I know my son, I'm actually more removed, but okay. He was too busy to handle this. He's been stressed out, family issues. And I told him I'd help step in, you know, I believe we've reached out to several other companies, and you know, apparently we didn't land anything with them. That's why we have you guys out here today.
Tell me a little bit more about when you reached out to these other companies. How did that go?
Well, from what I remember, you know, they sent a guy out here, and he had a patch on his eye, one eye. So that, to me, was, first of all, how can you see a leak in the roof?
Yeah.
If you only have one eye, you know. So that was a bit of a distraction. I don't think that they did a good job. Another company, you know, I think their prices was just way too high for the amount of work that we needed. So it just wasn't a good experience overall.
And why do you say that?
Why do I say what?
Why do you say that what they did previously didn't work? Do you have an idea why maybe a repair didn't take?
Well, we didn't get as far as them actually doing the repairs. Okay. We only got to the point where we had them come and look out. It just didn't feel like, I've been an entrepreneur, successful brothel owner and casino owner for a long time, and I've worked with, I know excellence when I see it. I just didn't think that these guys had what it took. And so we didn't even get as far as them doing any fixing. And then they threw out some outrageous pricing that, you know, I could be wrong, but it just seemed like a bit much.
All right. So what's going to happen if you don't get these leaks fixed?
Well, hopefully I'll find... I was going to say a flood. Hopefully not a flood, yeah. I mean, it's going to affect our business flow. It's going to affect our cash flow. You know, people are going to get wet, and people are going to complain, and riots might break out. I don't know. God knows.
And why would it be an issue if this leak was to affect your cash flow, maybe even revenue?
Well, I think you know, if I put myself in somebody else's shoes, I don't want to sit in a stadium where water's, you know, falling on my head. And I wouldn't go back. That would affect our bottom line.
And what would happen if people started not coming back to your venue?
We'd just have a big old empty stadium. You know, eventually, we wouldn't be able to keep up with the bills. I don't imagine, because they pay the bills. So.
Yeah. So what kind of money are we talking about? How is that going to impact you, money wise? What kind of numbers are we looking at you losing?
Oh gosh, I want to say probably in the billions, most right. likely, yeah.
All
it's
right.
a big stadium.
Alright, so on a scale of 1 to 10, how committed are you to getting this fixed?
Probably 11.
Alright.
Yeah.
And would you be willing to pay a little bit more to do it right the first time?
Absolutely.
And not have somebody out here multiple times?
Absolutely.
Alright. And who else cares about this issue?
Well, like I said, it's my son, but he's just going through some stuff right now, you know, some family issues. But other than that, it's just me, really.
Okay. And what are the chances that maybe we could have a meeting, the three of us, somewhere near in the future?
Yeah. We can make that happen, you know. We'd like to get this done ASAP, so when you say near in the future.
Yeah, soon.
In the next couple of days, maybe?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
And what's kind of like your decision-making process once you receive a estimate for repairs? What do you do? Do you just go ahead and sign it, or do you have a meeting? How do you guys make that decision?
Yeah.
Yeah?
We sign it if we like what we're seeing, you know, if it makes sense money-wise on paper. And yeah, we just, you know, the buck stops with me. You know, I'm the guy.
All right. So let's go ahead. Well, and take a look on the roof. Mm-hmm. Do you want to come with me so you can see it for yourself?
No, man, I'm too old to be climbing roofs. You know, that's why I'm going to pay you guys to go up on the roof. So.
All right. I'll take some pictures to share with you.
Uh-huh.
But before I get up there, let's set a meeting for in 2 days from now.
Excellent.
Where I can present my estimate to you and your son. How's that sound?
Sounds good.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and send this to you right now. From boom. This should be in your Outlook calendar.
Damn. Got it.
All right. Good to see you. All
right. Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
Good day.
What do you guys have to say about this, about Leland?
So I think you did a great job as far as the script and all of it. My suggestion would be if you focus on your physiology, it would affect your tonality.
Yeah.
And that's a big thing because, like he was saying, like the nonverbal and the tonality aspect is far more of the communication than the actual words coming out of your mouth.
Yeah.
And it's just a slight difference. You already know the script. The script's the more challenging part to master. It's just being aware of like even on the phone. Like when I'm on the phone making calls, like I'll stand up and make sure that I have that like physiology that's gonna be how I wanna show up on that call as if I was standing face to face with that person.
Every time I make a phone call, I take my feet off my desk.
No. Well, the one thing that I watched, like I watched how engaged you were in what you were saying when your hand came out of your pocket and when you were like using your hands as you were describing things, and then when you had your hands back in your pocket. And there were parts of the sequence of everything that you could tell that you weren't as comfortable with.
Yeah.
And
it sounds like.
it's just something that like, you have the whole thing, just own it and just step into it and shine, man, because you have that.
Yeah, that was awesome.
I think you did a fantastic job like getting, I don't know if every point was like buried hard enough as Ryan wants it, if that makes sense. I don't know if you went as deep as you could have, but I think you got to the point of qualifying that you were a good candidate to sell a roof to this guy.
But I think you went it out really well, but I think that you maybe could have taken your time in the compelling reasons.
Like, yeah, a little bit more.
Yeah, just go even deeper there. And I think for me, because I was answering in a way where I could learn as well, some things that I'm learning from this process. And I think that the going deeper, for me even, it's going to allow you to relax in that space. Because you're waiting for them to think, so it's almost like you're using their time.
I mean, you're throwing shit at him like he's a brothel. And how's he supposed to...
That was hard. So, anybody else have anything to just compliment or feedback constructive?
I think it's mainly non-verbal, man. It's your verbal, you got it. You're right on point. I think I would get my hands and stuff. Like I said, I think that's it. That's the only thing I could see at all.
And the more comfortable I get with it, the more, like he said, you can tell when I'm a little less comfortable, my hands go back in my pocket. And the guns in the holster.
And just a comfortable place.
This actually relaxes you. That's when you're just standing.
Cool.
And then he had to work the whole time. I'm like, I wonder if we could trace and work out.
Dude, you should say something like that. I mean, that would make people laugh.
That's good.
Like, that stuff makes, that's
the SOB part. The SOB is like when you're being authentic. Yeah. When you're showing your quirks and you're being a little bit vulnerable of like this is who I am.
Hey, barter is smarter.
Well, it gives people a sense of trust because it's like if I feel like I'm not seeing exactly who you are, then I don't know that our communication is 100. Well,
Ryan said you're not supposed to become friends with the person. In the end, that's one thing that I always do. I don't become friends with them, but I at least want to know something more about them.
There's a difference between friends and friendly, and you can definitely be friendly and still be business like.
Well, just relevant. It's just relevant for that's the topic.
Totally.
To call them up and want to hang out with them if they're getting a roof bid isn't relevant.
Did you guys hear him say, what are the chances? I needed to write the whole thing up. What are the chances?
Yeah, I wrote that down. What are the chances of us making or getting a meeting or whatever? But
that was the only
thing I really didn't like in the briefing.
So yeah, that was important. I think when you asked who else cares about this and you mentioned, you know, your son, I think the best question to piggyback off that is not what are the chances, because it sounds like a roll on the dice there. It's,
well, he's a casino owner.
It's it's how do we include him in the conversation?
Yeah.
That's it. Like, get them to kind of tell you how they're going to include. And then I noticed you picked up on timeline to solving it. He already answered it.
Yeah.
So that was good that you didn't like. I was sad that you'd ask the same question because he already told you. So I think we have to be careful. Like, let's not be asking questions that they've already given the answer to. That makes it sound like we're not really listening. So I think that was really good. The invite, we skipped the invite in the beginning, but you did it later.
We did skip the invite in the beginning.
I loved the way you talked about other companies and the experience and stuff.
That was clutch.
That was awesome, dude. You really turned a corner there because it was like you had the one guy with the eye patch.
You can't see.
It's
like, how is he gonna get up on the roof?
Yeah, a little distracting.
I'm on camera. I just, as soon as I heard that, I was like, "That's not going into this."
That's awesome, man. That was so good.
Because even in that, you could have maybe played into that whole
just humor, right? Just the fun. The fun. I mean, that's just.
Listen. There's people left and right for that.
Hey, on a serious note. Like, I was watching Tom versus Time on Facebook Live. Dude, you guys have to watch that. It's so good. Tom versus Time, about Tom Brady. He's so good. And dude, you're really good. And you're really good. Like, you've really taken huge strides. But you're here to get 1% better. You're here to get 1% better.
Yeah.
And like, these are the 1% betters for you, you know? And I think you get 1% better with tonality. You get 1% better with just being authentic. You know the fundamentals, and I think we just kind of polish those. It's just that much. That's the next level that breaks you through to the next level. But you notice what he said. He goes, you said decision process. He goes, well, yeah, you know, if we'll sign it if we like what we see. And that would have been a good opportunity to be like, well, let's pretend you like what you saw. What would have to be in there for you to like it? Just like, why would you, why would something be something that you would like? Let's talk about that.
Yeah.
And then that way he could say, well, years of business is important to me. Well, certainly price, although I told you I'd invest a little bit more. I don't want it to be out of, well, let's talk about that for a second. What would out of left field look like to you? I mean, you had the other guy come in. Tell me more about that. Well, he was 50,000. You're like, dude, I'm already going to be north of that. He may not have been a fit, right?
Yeah.
Perhaps. Mm-hmm. But then you can push back and say, let's talk about this for a second. We're talking about millions of dollar problem. And if you don't spend the money to do it right and get the real cause of the problem, in fact, you may have to replace this. This may be in a situation where you have to invest in a full replacement. I'll let you know that, and I'll tell you what I think is best for you. However, I just wanted to kind of bring that up earlier. Is that good?
You know. No, it makes sense. And my thought process was going out. I haven't looked at the roof yet. And we're going to be meeting with him and his son. We've already got that meeting set up. So then we can kind of run this again with his son there too. And get the value created with both of them.
Good.
And then present pricing and value issues.
Good.
Because we weren't that far, in my opinion. We didn't make it that far because I wasn't with all the decision makers.
Sure.
And I hadn't seen the roof yet.
Okay.
But I could have done some of that stuff.
That was a nice little window to be like, ooh, there you go. Like, so you, what do you mean when you say if you like what we see?
Yeah, I like that.
Tell me more about what that have to look like for you to like it.
Clearly likes hookers and money, you know, casino.
So if I slap like a bikini model on the front of the proposal, or it means we're gonna get it.
We're good.
He brought up an excellent point, though. So in the restart, like if you are with a half decision owner, you got to get the other one. At where do you rewind it back to? I mean, straight back to they need it, or do you pick it up?
All right, that's a good question. Where do you think if there's one thing that we want more than anything to get done, where would we go if we had a second meeting with an owner and the other person?
I think you have to, I think we said it yesterday, you have with the actual owner, you have to express his hardships to that new person.
I would probably recap two to three. I would recap that.
You're basically all over first base again, but you have more context that was compelling enough for that person to get you in front of the actual decision maker.
Yeah.
So that really just got you back on first.
So your son said,
your son was saying XYZ.
Would you agree
with
that?
That's his perspective. Can you tell me what yours would look like?
Yeah.
Tell me more about that. How would that, blah, blah, blah. And then you're going to get a different story, I guarantee you. 5 out of 10 times, the other 5 are going to be like, I mean, I had an owner that was like, his compelling reason, the son was, I want people to thrive in my business. The other owner, they're both partners. His compelling reason was, I don't want to have to lay people off through the recession. It was different. One was like intending on growing people. The other one was, I just don't want to miss.
Pain and pleasure. I mean, that was really the
difference. It was like, but those are the both of them were owners, and I got both of them to share their both individual compelling reasons that I can step in and help, right? So, man, good man. Good job.
And you're left in the dust, unless I'm stuck by you. You're a sunflower, I think your love would be too much, or you'd be left in the dust. All right, so I hope you got a lot out of that. So here are your action items now. I want you to go ahead and press pause and ask around the room, what is the single biggest takeaway from this module? What struck a chord? What rang a bell? What are you going to start doing, stop doing? What did you pick up on? And let me tell you, if somebody says something that you were going to say, go ahead and say, hey, what he said, but, or in addition to that, I want to add, this is something else I learned. I want everybody to kind of really start to create
a sense of commonality around this and singing the same sheet of music, I like to call it, same playbook, and really kind of getting unified, and obviously not be robotic at all, but to just get better. This is the time to get better. So also, I want, when you're done with that conversation, if you haven't done it, press pause and finish it. And then from there, I want you to take the script that you have and practice with a friend, a spouse, or team members. You know, get comfortable with this. This is going to be something that I guarantee you, if you master, like I said, you will have that sales nirvana. You will be a machine, and you will be unstoppable. Know that the friction is normal, and that the failure is feedback. And let's have a good relationship with failure so that we can get better. I guarantee you, you're going to be completely a different person as you guys muscle through the changes that come from this, and you don't stop. You're going to be incredible and be the number one in your market. Also, attend the weekly Q&A calls for support and immediate feedback from me. If you have a situation, if you have a question, if you have some, you know, head trash that you're kind of working through that you can't seem to get around, you needed the right perspective, your time is to come on those calls, and I will support you. So I'm looking forward to you guys getting into the continuation of these modules where you go into positioning statements all the way through social selling, you know, LinkedIn, networking, getting appointments. I mean, I'm going to go through every single nook and cranny of how to be successful in sales and transition to this new level. So really glad you are on, and I will talk to you soon. Have a good one.